Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the ice for the presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy.
Goes to the most valuable player in the playoffs. The unanimous selection.
What's going on, guys? Rob Diesel back with another edition of The Breakdown. And here we are, four teams left, aka the semifinals. And the point of the playoffs, at least in my opinion, where we could seriously start discussing who is in the running for the Conn Smythe Trophy. So, I took a look at the four remaining teams. I wanted to find the front runner for each. And two things struck me. Number one, they all play the same position. And number two, all four of those players have spent the playoffs shutting down some of the best offensive players on planet Earth. Okay, let's start with Vegas and the guy who always has a big smile on his face that the hockey world just keeps writing off, only to have him prove yet again just how good he is. Marc-Andre Fleury, playing in his 15th consecutive playoff season. And think about what it takes to shut down a guy like Nathan MacKinnon in the playoffs. He's been incredible. Carey Price, frustrated this year's Rocket Richard winner, and let's face it, is the main reason the Montreal Canadiens are one of the four remaining teams. And has any goalie made difficult saves look so easy? It should surprise absolutely no one that Andrei Vasilevskiy is leading the defending champs on another deep run, but that shouldn't mean he shouldn't be in the running for the Conn Smythe Trophy. He already has a couple shutouts and a pretty impressive save percentage. And finally, Semyon Varlamov shut down two guys named Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin before out-dueling Tuukka Rask in the second round. Look, are there other candidates for the award right now? Of course, but it's the guys in the pads that are the frontrunners. And this should really come as no surprise if you just look at history. Sure, we haven't seen a goalie win the Conn Smythe in some time. In fact, the last one to do it, Jonathan Quick, back in 2012. But of the 55 winners of the award, 16 of them were goalies, second only to centermen who have won it 19 times. The only player to ever win the award three times, Patrick Waugh, a goalie. First player to win it in back-to-back years, Bernie Perron, another goalie. The only rookies to ever win it, Cam Ward, Ron Hextall, Patrick Waugh, and Ken Dryden, all goalies. And four of the five players to win it, despite being on the losing end, you guessed it, goalies. And when you come back to this season, the three centermen nominated for the Hart Trophy and the top five scorers in the regular season are all watching the semifinals because of these goaltenders. So in a couple of weeks, when Gary Bettman is standing next to the Conn Smythe Trophy, waiting for a break in the booze so he can announce the winner, my money is on one of these four guys. Okay, a couple other things before we go. If you ask hockey fans in Canada who they cheer for once their team gets bumped from the playoffs, they usually fall into one of two groups. The first will cheer for absolutely no one. They are going to stick to the loyalty of their team. The second will cheer for whatever Canadian team is still standing. So I think the person in charge of lighting at the CN Tower and Niagara Falls probably falls into group number two. And finally, man, has this trade ever come full circle. These two were swapped in that deal between the Habs and the Golden Knights back in 2018. Now, Max Pacioretty is just the second player in NHL history to serve as a full-time captain of the Montreal Canadiens and then face the club in the playoffs, Doug Harvey being the other. And Nick Suzuki will spend this series trying to show the Golden Knights that they should have kept the player they drafted in 2017.